We all had made plans to go on the ski trip. My four other roommates all piled into my Ford Explorer, and I was driving.
Float your head, all the answers.
We left at 10 o'clock at night, which was our first mistake. Second mistake was we didn't really check the weather. There was an ice storm.
But something happens, don't see it coming.
We're on 80, headed towards Aspen, and the road started to curve to the right, and the wheels didn't respond, and I frantically just started spinning the wheel, and we kept going straight. The next thing I know, we're just sliding off to the left of the road. We started spinning out of control, and we flipped, and the driver's side of the car was the first thing that hit.
Life keeps tumbling.
The first thing I remember is the initial impact. The roof caved in, and I felt this horrible pain in my back. I could hear myself screaming. I was screaming prayers, and I didn't know what was going on. I thought I was dying.
Climb to heaven, and you throw yours.
My roommate was killed, and he was sitting behind me, and I was paralyzed.
Joey McTigue's accident took place on January 3, 2005. Joey was airlifted to West Holt Memorial Hospital in Atkinson, Nebraska, just outside Lincoln. An Indiana native, McTigue was far from home.
I still think that phone call was brutal, but there is no other way when a doctor has that kind of information to give someone. There were so many things I didn't know, so all those questions were racing through my head. All I did know was that he was paralyzed. There's a whole part of you that just does not want to believe it.
Joey went into surgery the evening of the 3rd with a broken back and a shattered spine. Joey was paralyzed from the chest down.
I went through the surgery. It doesn't really do anything in terms of improving your chances for return of functionality.
And I knew he would have use of his hands and that he would be able to, that he was not going to be a quadriplegic. And I knew that the difference between a paraplegic and a quadriplegic is huge. Being mainly independence and dependence.
Joey was sent to the Rehabilitation Institute in Chicago, where he spent 5 weeks. But it wasn't until his return home to South Bend when Joey realized his life would never be the same.
That really didn't settle in until I got home back to South Bend and I pulled up to my house. That's where things really start to sink in.
Put yourself in that position. Who was like you not that long ago, and so much of their world has been shredded.
The contrast between being perfectly able-bodied to being wheelchair-bound, that contrast is just so scary, so frustrating, so upsetting.
Despite his frustration and anger, Joey knew that he would overcome these obstacles. It was his passion for life that kept him going.
It was then when I was like, okay, how am I going to deal with this, you know? And it's just like, you know what? You have to take it as every day as it comes and just really take each moment and be optimistic and just realize that, you know, this is what we have to deal with and you're gonna be all right.
He was so optimistic already. I mean, just, I can't get over how strong he was for everybody. He's just such a positive force all the time.
You know, I just had this optimism that I was gonna be okay. That's part of my personality coming through, is I'm just optimistic in general.
The first morning that I went to therapy with him, which was the first time that he sat up in a chair and knew what it felt like. I remember thinking, this is going to be awful. It's going to be a complete setup for realizing all that he's lost and all that he won't be able to do. He looked at his therapist and just said, he said, it's like I'm floating, and he started laughing. And I'm sure in some ways the laughter was almost a way to keep himself from crying, but at the same time I just remember thinking, you know, he's just looking at this as it's a whole new experience, and it feels like he's floating and he's going to make the best of this.
And that's what he did. Joey returned to the University of Iowa in the fall of 2005 to continue studying economics.
The more time goes by, the better I get at things. I can dress myself. I can do everything completely on my own now. It's really altered my perception of life in general. The one thing that I've really realized is the only thing that you really truly have control over is your mental attitude. Just there's so much stuff that I worried about that is so not important and so in the overall scheme of things, and it's something that you cannot realize until something just like this big, this tragic happens to you. It just doesn't come into focus. You can't see it. It's okay to be different, and I never, you know, I always was wanting to try and fit in, and I always wanted to be the cool guy. God meant for this to happen because it forces me to grow up, to realize how important family is, and to not take your health for granted, and to make the most out of every situation.
Really, you got to look at it and be totally amazed. I think anyone that that even touches Joey or really gets to know him at all can't help but be inspired.
I never really was happy, and I don't think I ever would have been. I would always feel like there's something missing, and now that there is something missing, I enjoy things so much more because I appreciate so much more. I try and make so much more out of my day, and I try and make a conscious effort not to judge people. It's all about your experiences, how you handle things, and putting your own self into your life as much as you can and making it work. And I never looked at it like that before my accident, and that's like the greatest thing that's come out of this. Screw fitting in, screw trying to be the cool dude, and I'm so grateful for that. I feel like such an enlightened, it sounds stupid, but I feel like I'm so much ahead of the game in comparison to other people that just don't see the big picture. My name is Joey McTigue, and I'm a paraplegic. It's a long way.